In this video, I am going to show you the GroupBy node and how to use it. The GroupBy node performs grouping of data and aggregation of values. Here we have a small example workflow with some customer data. We will perform different aggregation methods with the GroupBy node. First, the basic count and percent, followed by some advanced counting. Then we will look at concatenation and statistics. And finally, have a look at data aggregation on special data types. First, let's start with the dialog of the GroupBy node. This is the Groups tab. Here, you select the columns upon whose values the groups are built. For example, column gender contains two values, M and F, and builds two groups, all of the female and all of the male people in the dataset. Column selection is performed through an include-exclude frame. Click Add and Remove to respectively add or remove columns, or Add All or Remove All to respectively add all or remove all columns for the grouping operation. Below, you can configure some advanced settings, such as the possible names for the resulting column, the enabling of the highlighting property, the in-memory processing for better performances on small data tables, the retention of the original row order as in the input table, the maximum number of unique values per column to use to build the groups, this is to avoid the possibility of memory overloading, and the delimiter character to introduce to some aggregation methods such as string concatenation. Next, the aggregation tab. Once you have decided how to build the groups, you need to choose the aggregation method to apply inside the groups. There are three aggregation tabs: manual aggregation, pattern-based aggregation, and type-based aggregation. Let's start with the manual aggregation tab. First, select a column for the aggregation. On the left, you have all the columns that are available for aggregation, that is all but the grouping columns. Select your column and add it to the list. Notice that you can perform multiple aggregations on the same column by adding it multiple times. Then let's select the aggregation method. To get a list of all aggregation methods, select the description tab. The aggregation part of the right frame is actually a menu that contains all applicable aggregation methods for this column type. If you want to perform the same aggregation on multiple columns, explore the right-click menu of this list. The count aggregation method counts the total number of records per group independently from the column values. That means count returns the same value no matter which feature you perform it on. The missing value checkbox lets you decide whether or not to ignore missing values for the aggregation. If you check it, missing values are included, which is necessary to make the count feature independent. The same holds for percent, as it is the count divided by the total number of rows times 100. Let's continue with advanced counting. We look at the unique count, the missing value count, and the mode. If you rather want to count the number of different unique values in a feature, you can use unique count. Another version of count is the missing value count, that just returns the number of missing values per group. To determine the most prominent value of a feature, that is the value that appears most often in a group, select the aggregation method mode. Now let's look at the concatenation methods in KNIME. Concatenation is known as a string function, but it works on other types as well, but the output is always a string, not a collection. Concatenation creates a string by listing all values in the order they appear, even if they are duplicated. That is great for many groups with a small number of values, like products in a market basket. However, in some cases, we are interested in the list of unique occurrences. This is produced by the unique concatenate. The unique concatenate lists the occurring values only once. Another related and informative aggregation is the unique concatenate with count, that adds the number of occurrences to each value. The GroupBy node offers a lot of statistical aggregations as well, like mean, sum, standard deviation, even kurtosis. If you don't know a method offered by KNIME, click on the description tab. It lists all possible aggregation methods in a short explanation. Another two popular methods are min-max, respectively first-last. While their names seem rather obvious, it is important to know how they work. As you can see, max returns a different value than last, because max returns the maximum value in the group, while last returns the last value according to the current sorting of the table. They are equal to each other if they are performed on the feature which the table is sorted according to. Finally, let's have a look at data aggregation on special data types. KNIME does not only offer aggregation methods for standard types. If you select a special type, like date, you can find some dedicated aggregation methods. For date, you have date range and mean date as examples. Note that general methods, like min and max, return the input type.